I'm going to tell you the differences between being a pathologist and a pathologist assistant so you can decide if becoming a pathologist assistant is right for you. And if it is right for you, then you can start applying to schools and hopefully one day work as a PA. Hey, my name is Luke. I'm a pathologist assistant working in Western Canada. And if you want to learn about how to become a pathologist assistant or discover some of the things that I've learned about while in school or at work, hit the subscribe button down below so you can stay tuned in. Okay, so first off, a pathologist. A lot of TV shows will show a pathologist as someone who just does autopsies, and while it's pretty easy to explain in 5 or 10 seconds, it doesn't really capture the full essence of what a pathologist actually does. And if you can understand what they do, then it'll be easier to understand what a pathologist assistant can do. Pathology is the part of medicine that involves the study and diagnosis of disease, and a pathologist is able to diagnose these diseases through the examination of body fluids, tissues, organs, or sometimes, in case of an autopsy, an entire body. This examination is a combination of gross examination, so what you can see with your eyes, as well as microscopic examination, so looking at tissue and cells under an actual microscope. And by looking at cells like this, a pathologist can tell if those cells are adapting to injury, if there's inflammation, if there's healing, if those cells are dying, and also if there's cancer. And by using special chemicals or antibodies to show special cellular components of these cancers, a pathologist can tell what type of cancer it is, where it probably came from, and what sort of treatment it'll respond best to. So yes, a pathologist can do autopsies, but it is a very small component of their overall day. And there's a lot of pathologists who don't do them at all and prefer to just diagnose surgical specimens. And if that sounds like a lot of work, then it is. A pathologist is a medical doctor who goes through a 4-year medical degree program, then a 5-year residency, and will often specialize or do a fellowship, which can take another 1 to 2 years. So that's the Coles Notes of what a pathologist does, but what about a pathologist assistant? Where do we fit into all of this? Most websites will give a generic answer of being a physician extender, but they don't necessarily explain how you do this or how that's actually useful for a pathologist. So pathologist assistants, or PAs, are trained to do the gross examination that pathologists also do. And based on that examination, they'll select a representative piece of tissue from the larger specimen, and that will get turned into slides that the pathologist can ultimately get, look at cells under the microscope, and give a diagnosis based on that. This way, a pathologist can focus on looking at slides and diagnosing without having to worry about also doing the gross examination themselves. Now, this is especially helpful in hospitals that don't have a lot of pathologists or that receive a lot of surgical specimens during the day. It would be a ton more work if a pathologist had to do all the gross examination themselves, which is called grossing, as well as do the microscopic examination and give out diagnoses. At the very least, it would make for some very long days, or for pathology results to take forever to come out. So although PAs don't diagnose, the gross examination that we do is very important in forming that actual final diagnosis. And because of that, we go through a 2-year master's degree training program to make sure we can actually do this job. We regularly consult with pathologists and occasionally surgeons, especially on difficult or complex cases, but we spend far less time in school. I think the job is a lot less stressful than being in the position of having to give someone a final diagnosis that can sometimes literally be life or death. And while you make only about 25% as much of a pathologist, I think that trade-off is worth it. Are these the differences you thought there would be? Or did you even know what a pathologist assistant did before this? Let me know down in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.